Thanks very much, Clarence Mason. Quite a man, I guess. But, well, what an impact Razor Ramon has made here recently. I tell you.
Cross, what is this? Come on.
Well, it's as an athlete that is 6'7", close to 300 pounds. Hey, this guy can't help it that he looks like a movie star. This guy can't help it that he's a thoroughbred. If the people with a plow horse mentality can't understand this guy, that's their problem. You know, it's not my problem that I'm recruiting great athletes to come to the World Wrestling
Federation. There's no doubt in my mind that he's a great athlete. He's here in the World Wrestling Federation.
And perfect, even though he's not perfect, isn't this the bottom line? That they're bringing great athletes to the World Wrestling Federation?
Yeah, I'll agree with you, yes.
This company is all about competition.
No doubt about it.
And if it was entirely up to Vince McMahon, would have probably 30 clowns on the roster. You could have a doink, a dink, a dank, a duke, you know, the whole nine yards.
Well, instead he's got Mr. Perfect, Bret Hart, Stone Cold, Shawn Michaels. We got the greatest athletes in the world right here in the World Wrestling Federation. I should know, I'm perfect.
I rest my case. Razor Ramon and the two sports star Bob Holly.
Who's a great athlete, by it?
He really is. Bob Holly's a great competitor. Certainly, Bob Holly, I know, will be traveling to Indianapolis. That's got to be one of his favorite cities. Holly, an avid race car aficionado. Of course, the Indianapolis, the home of the Indy 500. Razor Ramon. Sir, been hanging pretty closely with Big Daddy Cool Diesel in recent days since they both arrived here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Inseparable.
Gotta wonder. I never did really find out why Razor and Diesel were looking on in the aisle last Monday on Raw during that big melee involving Shawn Michaels and Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Well, they're taking a look at all the great competition here. They know sooner or later, if they work their way up, they'll get a shot at the top dogs here in the World Wrestling Federation.
We can see that Bob Holly's got a lot of competitive spirit, blatantly breaking the rules, pulling the hair, and then nailing Razor Ramon with a right hand. I can't wait to hear what Bret Hart's going to say tomorrow night on Raw. Fort Wayne, Indiana is going to be so electric tomorrow night. But I'm sure that Vince McMahon will be the one that'll do the interview instead of me, the one that's bringing Bret Hart back to the WWF.
And you bet I won't be any talking. I'll be all action, Ross, when it comes to Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
I can't wait to be sitting right there at ringside calling your match. I know the holes. McMahon hasn't learned a new hole in 25 years. Oh, what a move. Oh, my.
I mean, you know, Jim Ross, when I was in the ring wrestling, you never did the color commentary for one of my matches.
Oh, it was before my...
I hope you can keep up with it.
That's right. I'm prepared for you.
In fact, I'd rather have you do it than McMahon. I think you have a better chance of keeping up with... I move so fast, so quick.
I think most of the athletes here feel the same way. Bob Holly's got to mount some offense here. Razor Ramon looking pretty dominant. There's a hard Irish whip. And Holly's in trouble. Don't you go away. We'll be right back. Razor with a suplex, and Holly is in more trouble. Welcome back, everybody. Thanks for being with us here this morning. Jim Ross and Mr. Perfect with you. We'll go back to Doc Hendricks in Indianapolis before we sign off here this morning. And the bad guy looking pretty good here today, Perfect.
No doubt about it. He's taking his time out there. Each move he's got, it's just, his timing looks, well, it's not perfect, but it's pretty good.
Nice sound strategy here by Razor Ramon, and Bob Holly again trying to free himself from this predicament. Well, I'll tell you something, my heart is beating faster and faster thinking about tonight's pay-per-view matchup. You know, I want to ask McMahon, man-to-man, face-to-face, why he shirked his responsibility and didn't sanction. Oh, my! Wait a minute! Inside cradle! Almost a three count there by the pugnacious Bob Holly.
So what about McMahon now? What are you talking about?
Well, you know, it's non-sanctioned, the buried alive match. Hey, we don't want anything to do with it. We'll take the money, but we don't want any responsibility. Fall away slam. That is vintage Razor Ramon. 6'7", close to the 300-pound mark, as we mentioned earlier. Certainly has a lot of quickness. And now, Bob Holly is, he may be entering dead man's curve here.
Uh-huh. That way.
Holly's a competitor, I'll tell you that. Bob Holly is pound for pound one of the toughest men that you'll ever see, I can tell you that. And there's an inverted atomic drop. And Holly with a high impact clothesline.
Come on!
some momentum here.
Bob Holly, two-sport athlete, right? How about Mr. Perfect, 100-sport athlete? Imagine when I get back in the ring tomorrow night, Ross. Now that was great.
Great drop kick right on the jaw.
That could do it.
One, two, and a half. A long, long two count for Bob Holly on Razor Ramon. And there's a hurricanrana and a lateral press and another near fall.
Razor Ramon's in trouble here, Ross.
He really is. You think McMahon would know what that move is? He would say, oh, my. What a move. Oh, my. What a move. Let's get you ready for tonight, folks. I don't know why I'm not doing the play-by-play. I know the fans would rather have me doing the play-by-play as McMahon, but when you know, when you own the company, you can do any damn thing you want. That's just the way
that it is. I've been through that in my life, believe me, before. I used to work for the Ganyas.
Rich people get all the breaks. Suplex off the top. Old Bob Holly folded up like the proverbial accordion. And the end may be near.
We're going to get the sign from Razor, I think, right here. That's it.
You know, another thing about this guy, he's young. He's young. I mean, he's got a great career ahead of him. Razor's Edge? Why not?
Why not?
It's Sunday morning. No better time for the Razor's Edge. Bob Holly may dispute that point. And down he comes. Well, pitcher's worth a thousand words.
I wouldn't mind giving Bob Holly some advice. You know, like I did Merrill. I think Holly has potential.
Well, you've helped Merrill. There's no doubt about that.
Yeah.
Mark Merrill's a great Intercontinental champion. Maybe not for long. Let's take another look. Nice move here. How would you describe this?
Well, if you take a good close look at it off the top rope, boom, right on the back of the head of Bob Holly. The Razor's Edge, forget about it. This one's
the World Wrestling Federation. For over 50 years, the revolutionary force in sports entertainment.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome to WWF Sunday Morning Superstars. We're going to kick it off with a huge tag team matchup. I'm Jim Ross, alongside Mr. Perfect. Thanks for being with us. And also this morning, you're going to see one-on-one Wild Man Mark Merrill take on Goldust.
Mark Merrill, the biggest sucker in the World Wrestling Federation.
When you cross the path of Stone Cold Steve Austin. And believe me, Bret the Hitman Hart is going to find out at the Survivor Series what Stone Cold is all about.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, we're having some audio problems here, but joining us in our studios live in Stamford, Connecticut, the legendary Bret the Hitman Hart. We will talk to Bret Hart live from our WWF studios right here this morning on WWF Superstars. This should be quite a tag team matchup, ladies and gentlemen, to kick it off here. You know, Razor and Diesel are on the same Survivor Series team as Vader and Farouk. They'll face Savio Vega, Yokozuna, newcomer Flash Funk, and a mystery partner, Perfect.
Now, I wonder who that could be. Don't be looking my way.
Razor and Diesel have been forming quite an impressive combination in recent weeks. This is the first time we've seen them together, I think, here on WWF Superstars to take on Aldo Montoya and Barry Horowitz. Well, I'll tell you something, what a volatile weekend we've had. People are trying to track down Stone Cold Steve Austin, who has not been at any of his wrestling commitments. Austin was not in Richmond on Friday night. Austin was not in Landover at the US Air Arena yesterday afternoon. And everybody is talking that Stone Cold is making his way towards Cincinnati, Ohio, where tomorrow night, live on Raw, we'll have a satellite in Cincinnati. And I hope we will not have the same problems we're having right now with our audio. But we'll have a satellite in Cincinnati tomorrow night to talk to Brian Pillman to see how he's doing since his ankle reconstruction surgery.
Stone Cold Steve Austin definitely destroying everything in his path. I can't see anybody slowing this guy down.
It will be Diesel starting out with Barry Horowitz. And you got to be impressed with the athleticism of Diesel, a guy that's 6'8", 6'9", somewhere in that neighborhood, around 300 pounds, tagging in the bad guy, Razor Ramon.
And we'll see how they operate as a team here, Ross. You know, it's a whole different story when you're individual or you're in a team competition. Now, Survivor Series, you're going to be involved with four men on each team. Speaking of Survivor Series, what about the team that I've got put together with Hunter Hearst Helmsley, the new Intercontinental Champion, Goldust, the King, Jerry Lawler, and Crush on the same team?
Pretty fine team. We'll talk more about that in the broadcast as the bad guy easily manhandling Barry Horowitz here thus far. But don't discount the ability and the athleticism of Barry Horowitz. He's a very sound, fundamental athlete here. Tag was made. And Aldo Montoya with a backslide on Razor Ramon for a near fall and some nice double teaming by Horowitz and Montoya until then. I tell you, a good big man will always beat a average little man. You know, I saw Montoya last week. The one match I got to broadcast last Monday perfect on Raw was Montoya and Crush. Well, that was a spellbinder.
Just the one match you got?
That's it.
McMahon, right?
Oh, yeah. Of course, Raw tomorrow night on 1 hour early. So remember that, folks. I'll be reminding you that throughout the morning. Raw is on 1 hour early at 7:57 Eastern time. Irish whip to the far side. Now, that's impact, pal.
That's power. Diesel has got the power. Look at the size of this guy.
Hey, you know, I was talking to a guy this week. Well, this spill of beans here. I was talking to Paul Bearer over the weekend.
Uh-huh.
Paul Bearer is worried to death about the Survivor Series. Oh, my! Sidewalk slam when The Undertaker meets Mankind. Of course, Paul Bearer's going to be hanging from the ceiling of the garden in a cage.
Well, okay, let's say The Undertaker destroys Mankind once and for all. Paul Bearer still has to be lowered down from the ceiling inside that steel cage down to the ground sometime, and The Undertaker will be there waiting for him.
That's right, and that would not be a pretty sight in the garden for Paul Bearer. There's the quickness of Aldo Montoya. Montoya with that spinning heel, that kick that caught a glancing blow, really didn't work at all. Here comes Horowitz back in there. Horowitz has got a wrestle Razor. You're not going to brawl this man.
Come on, horrible wits. There you go.
Big mistake by Barry Horowitz with that self-adulation, patting himself on the back, and the end may be near now for Horowitz. You know, I had a long talk with Steve Austin last Monday afternoon, and I think that you're going to hear some of the same things that I have been saying about our good friend Vince McMahon. You're going to hear Austin echo all those sentiments. What a kick right to the face. We're going to play some footage up from Raw in a few moments. Well, I tell you what, this is a pretty good combination, Razor and Diesel. They just need some time to mesh, to get together.
Oh, I think they're gelling well as a team. I think this one's going to be over in a second.
Don't forget, Bret Hart is live in our studios in Stanford. It's the jackknife. Well, I tell you what, nobody has ever executed the jackknife like that man right there.
Wow.
And this one's over. Not a bad outing for this tag team, huh, Perfect?
No. Not bad at all.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take you back to last Monday on Raw. Vince McMahon thought he was Ted Koppel. Listen to this question. McMahon asked Stone Cold why Gorilla Monsoon hadn't punished him. Oh, what a question.
All right, and Rocky Balboa. We have a crowd of him.
Yeah.
And look at Hawkey. Hawkey making an exception. The Rocky Balboa. Feeling the spotlight. Likes to steal the spotlight from anyone. And I assure you that Rocky can wrestle a little bit better than the Honky Tonk Man can say.
Well, I have to say so.
What a reception for Rocky Maivia. The first ever three-generation WWF superstar. His grandfather, the High Chief Maivia. His dad. Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. Razor Ramon attacking Rocky Maivia.
Oh, that's just not fair. It was even before the bell.
Off the rope.
All right, there we go, Rocky.
And Rocky, oh, nice drop kick. His dad, Rocky Johnson, taught him how to drop kick just like that.
Oh, yeah. One of the best drop kicks in wrestling.
Oh,
Rocky Maivia. Standing side headlock. Of course, Rocky Johnson looking on, ladies and gentlemen, live. And Tampa Florida catching the elbow. Rocky Johnson, former WWF Tag Team Champion. He is hopeful his son likewise will be a champion. And Razor Ramon now from the other side. Crossroad, nicely executed. Quickly back to his feet. What a sensational athlete Rocky Maivia is.
I think Rocky's going to win. Rail him in, hook, line, and sinker like I did to all of you in my home sex video.
I must say that that was most unusual.
Unusual. The hottest thing you'll ever see, baby.
And what is Honky Tonk Man doing out here now?
What is he doing
here? Oh, my goodness. Whatever it is, he's up to no good. No doubt about that, ladies and gentlemen. Honky Tonk Man's out there to shake, rattle, and roll. Stay with us. Action will continue. We're live. The Ultimate Sports Theme Restaurant. The official All-Star Cafe. And Razor Ramon and Rocky Maivia. Oh, my goodness. Having a go in single competition. And Razor has been battering Rocky Maivia.
Well, you know, Razor's experience in the ring is definitely overpowering the naiveness, I guess you'd say, of Rocky Maivia, because he's got the upper hand.
And Rocky has been distracted repeatedly through the break by the Honky Tonk Man, who's been out at ringside, and again, as we said before, has really no reason to be out there other than to cause trouble. Razor now tries to set up the youngster. He's a rookie. Rocky Maivia from the other side. Person gets a big man
he
down.
May be a rookie, but he's
almost
good.
Enough to put him away. Oh, and a clothesline. And Razor now, after that clothesline, trying to capitalize on Rocky Maivia. Maivia to the buckle. Razor. All over it. Razor Ramon, we've seen him repeatedly throughout the night. Firstly, interfering in Diesel's matchup. And you wonder whether or not Diesel might interfere in this matchup,
come on,
although
Rocky.
The Honky Tonk Man out about ringside as we speak. And a look of concern on Sonny's face.
Rocky,
who obviously
come on, baby.
Are somewhat infatuated with Rocky Maivia.
Well, you know, why wouldn't I be? Look at him. If you were a woman, you'd be. Or maybe you are anyway.
No thanks.
You like that. You never know.
Rocky trying to get back to his feet. Right hand to the midsection and another one.
Oh, come on, Rocky. Get it together, baby.
Honky Tonk Man looking on. And Razor planting that knee right in the back of the neck, right in the back of the head, if you would, and rearing way back on the chin.
Oh, come on, Rocky. Don't give up, baby. Fire up.
And by the way, ladies and gentlemen, we're told that Todd Pettengill is making his way as we speak out to Times Square. But we are live in the All-Star Cafe, Shotgun Saturday Night, a most unusual setting as it is each and every week for a most unusual event, Shotgun Saturday Night.
That's one word for it.
Next week, by the way, ladies and gentlemen, we will be in San Antonio, Texas, live.
Oh, that's just humiliation there.
For Shotgun Saturday Night. And a yank of the hair there by Razor Ramon.
Let's go, Rocky! Let's go, Rocky!
And Razor doing everything to keep Rocky down on a canvas. Rocky, nonetheless, back up on his feet now. Off the rope and a knee squarely into the abdominal area. And Razor now with a clothesline to the back of the head and hurling through this. Oh, come on.
Come on. He's got to stick his nose in everybody's business.
And those aren't blue suede shoes Honky Tonk Man has on right now. They're boots. And on the receiving end of those boots, Rocky Maivia. And that Razor must be the man that Rocky's looking for.
Oh, no.
Here we go. Razor says no. Back to the drop.
Yeah, there we go.
And a rake in the face, and again, right back in. No, look at this. Here we go, Rocky spinning Razor around. What's he gonna do with him? Gets him up. Uh-oh, how about that?
Oh, yeah.
Shoulder breaker.
There we go, Rocky, it's over.
That's it, we got it. Rocky got him.
There we go, there's my boy. Raise his hand right there.
And Honky Tonk Man was looking at Razor Ramon. I don't think he's gonna be looking any better for this matchup. The official All-Star Cafe, the setting for Shotgun Saturday Night. We're having a blast inside, outside, out in Times Square, ladies and gentlemen. We've got Todd Pettengill somewhere out there doing something.
Todd, what's up, Todd?
Todd, can you hear us?